Hi everyone, it's continue again Hitman 3. Let's go. Eliminate Alexa Collins, find the case file.
Phineas Whitmer, private investigator. I have an appointment with Madame Carlyle.
Please wait.
Mr. Whitmer is here to see Madame Carlyle.
This is a restricted area and I can't let you through. You gotta move on.
Mr. Whitmer is here to see Madame Carlyle. You can go right in.
That is Phineas Whitmer, the famous private investigator hired by Madame Carlyle this morning. I'm curious why he's here. Maybe you should do some detecting yourself, 47.
What to do?
A famous private investigator summoned by Alexa Carlyle has arrived at Thornbridge Manor. If you take his place, it may be an opportunity to get close to Madame Carlyle.
Okay. I need to take him down. No.
Are you even aware that you are? Hey, you, stop.
Run.
And no one will get hurt.
Tango is going Bruce Lee.
Thank you.
we are in.
A great tragedy has fallen upon us, and I need a quick resolution, handled with absolute discretion.
Follow the private investigator.
And I don't give a toss about my fame, if that's what you're worried about. My lips are sealed.
Very well. I suppose you will want to start at the crime scene.
You assume too much, Madame Carlyle. The crime scene, if such exists, is never where I live.
Do as you wish. However, I expect a result in a timely fashion. Fernsby will take over from here.
I'm Mr. Fernsby, Butler. I will try to assist you as best I can. Where would you like to start your investigations?
Where's the family? I like to prime the suspects.
Madame Carlyle's family members are all on this floor. Maybe start in the city. If you'll follow me, it's great. Priming, you say. That sounds interesting.
It's like planting seeds that will grow into telling actions or words.
I see.
They bear. You are bold. Self-controlled and always a step ahead. All qualities of murderer would benefit from it.
What? Oh no, he's dying here. Oh no, not again.
I already have. And fruit, they bear. You are bold, not easily faced.
I think so I'll wait for him here.
All qualities of murderer would benefit from.
I
just one question. Is that burnt leather?
Run faster.
Someplace safe! Now!
Command, nothing to report.
Yay, I'm safe. Follow the private investigator.
Good today, sir.
Need to disguise myself as the private investigator.
An unusual connection to the place, even though you married into the family.
I do not. I mean, it is my husband's ancestral grounds. Of course I care, but what are you insinuating?
Just an observation.
If you're dressed like a Detective 47, you might as well act the detective. I suggest you go talk to the butler.
Let's talk to the butler.
Gregory, don't say more to that weird detective than you need to.
I was just having a laugh.
Mr. Fernsby, I'm ready to see the crime scene.
Very well, Mr. Whitmer. If you'll follow me, sir.
Follow Mr. Fernsby.
You good today, sir?
I feel obliged to point out that current affairs surrounding Madame Carlyle are of a delicate nature. You may be familiar with the recent announcement of her death. You will probably learn that the staged funeral is scheduled to take place tomorrow. Madam's children were not informed until this morning that their mother was in fact not dead at all. So please bear with them if they seem affected
by
a rather unusual situation. I trust I do not need to remind you that there will be consequences if word gets out that Madame Carlyle is still alive.
I'll consider her dead when I leave.
Before you inspect the crime scene, I will tell you this. The case concerns the death of Mr. Zachary, Madame Carlyle's younger brother. He was found dead in his bed this morning. The door was locked from the inside, and a suicide letter was found in his room. However, Madame Carlyle suspects foul play and will not accept that he took his own life. I've prepared some information for you. So please do come and see me when you've finished your investigation of the crime scene. This is Mr. Zachary's room, to my right.
Investigate Zachary's bedroom.
A locked room murder mystery, 47. I trust you'll get to the bottom of this.
Investigate Zachary's Carrie's bedroom. What do we have here?
Why don't you use your camera to scan the dead body, 47?
Throat markings indicate a rare, short-lived plant poison killed him. Spread shows time of death at around 10 o'clock last night.
You do know your poisons, 47.
Oh no. I don't know. investigate.
Zachary was shopping for New Wellingtons last night. Not exactly what you would expect from someone suicidal.
It's a pair of boots.
Zachary's suicide note. Also, a sample of handwriting. It could be relevant to compare to other samples to a
Zachary's suicide note.
Establish its authenticity.
Good guy. What else? This is so weird.
This could explain how the door was locked from the inside. Photocopy of the floor plans. Somebody's been researching the secret ins and outs of Thornbridge Manor. I believe you've done a thorough search of the crime scene, 47. Maybe it's time to see the butler. I'm curious about the information he's prepared for you.
Mr. Fernsby, I'm done with the crime scene.
Did you establish a time of death?
Zachary died around 10 o'clock last night.
Well, that means the staff were off duty. And Madame Carlyle and her security didn't arrive until this morning. That leaves Madam's family and myself as the only persons here when he died. And before you ask, no, I do not have an alibi. I was alone in my office at the time of death. Here's the material that I prepared for you. It's a list of the possible suspects and their quarters. Hopefully that will help you keep track of your findings. Please come and see me when you've solved the case, and I will take you to Madame Carlyle.
This is very useful information, 47. So how does one solve a murder mystery, 47? Motive, means, and opportunity, I believe. May I suggest you ask the suspects for alibis?
How tall?
Or perhaps you prefer searching the manor for clues first?
I'm serious. I have a friend who's a lawyer. She says that's the sweet, sweet lass. You should come and stay at my place in London. We can have her come over. Give you some tips.
I'm quite happy here, thanks.
Patrick Carlyle. Can you tell me where you were yesterday evening?
Shit, it's that sneaky butler, isn't it? He ratted me out. Elaine, give us some privacy, would you? Don't tell Mother, okay? She's really tense these days, and the last thing I need is more hassle. I took that pretty blonde, Rosie, for an evening stroll. I mean, how the fuck am I expected to cope for an entire weekend in this shithole? I'm bored out of my mind. If that's all, I think I'll get back to my slow death by boredom.
What did you think of Zachary?
Creepy as hell. No ambition. Imagine deciding to live in a museum. You know, Father says Zachary and Alexei used to be two of a kind. He had a great future ahead of him. Then suddenly, he just gave up everything. What an idiot. Thank God Daddy chose looks and brains over pedigree when he married Mummy. I don't have to worry about the inbreeding so customary in these circles. So, is that it?
The son of Emma and Gregory. The other suspects. They never say the location name.
Gregory Carlyle, can you tell me where you were yesterday evening?
Well, you're wondering about my alibi, Mr. Detective. Well, I left Thornbridge around 8:30 for a pint with Edward. I wish I had quiz night at the inn. On the other hand, staying here with Zachary, my obnoxious sister, and the wife sporting another one of her headaches would have been fate worse than death. The short of it, Zachary was very much alive when we left. I stayed for the last shout, and I was back here just before midnight. Is that all? Not very thorough, are you?
Gregory Collins, oldest child of Anissa. Where are the others?
Hammer Carlyle, can you tell me where you were yesterday evening?
Surely I'm not a suspect.
I need to account for everyone.
Well, I spent the evening with my family, but I got an awful migraine and had to take to bed. Everyone can attest to that. I believe I went up when the boys sat down for a drink around 8 o'clock. Anything else you want to know?
How did you feel about Zachary?
I might as well be honest. His presence was always awkward. But how do you have a meaningful conversation with a man who only cares about plants? In my opinion, Alexa bears some responsibility for how this ended. She supported his self-limiting behavior by letting him live here. Is that all?
Emma Callis, the wife of Gregory.
Music makes my heart soar.
You and me both.
Stand up.
That's a little too close.
Professor Edward Carlyle, can you tell me your whereabouts for last night?
Oh, yes. This dreadful business with Zachary. I stay at the local inn. You see, I prefer not to spend the night here at Thornbridge Manor. My brother Gregory came along for a nightcap. He'd never admit it, but I think he understands that I find this whole thing upsetting and wanted to provide some comfort. I believe we went to the Stag's Head around 8:30. If that's all, I have a speech to write.
Can you tell me about Zachary's behavior last night?
I certainly didn't expect him to commit suicide. Sure, he was upset by Mother's supposed death. But he seemed more engaged than usual. You should ask Rebecca, they had a long talk. Did you know that he hadn't left Thornbridge Manor in nearly 50 years? His plants, Mother, and the staff, all the company he had. Anything else I can do to help?
So I love this tour. Rebecca.
Mr. Fernsby?
Mr. Whitmer, you have enough evidence to present your case for Madame Carlyle?
No, not yet.
Come and see me when you do.
Rebecca.
That door leads to Emma and Gregory's room.
Thank you. Cannot go through it. Where is the robot? Oh, this is the room. Missing key. There's a way to get through here, it can be. Cannot go in. This Emma's room. Nothing here.
A keychain pendant for the greenhouse. What's that doing in Emma and Gregory's room, I wonder? And why is the key missing?
See how this game. Oh, this Emma's room, correct. I need to go to where now? Greenhouse. man is not here. So I go wrong. Missing propane flask. This is difficult at this game.
Now this is interesting, 47. A letter from Emma's mother stating that Emma is the illegitimate child of Alexa's late older brother, Montgomery. And listen to this. She claims to have witnessed Alexa and Zachary murder him. The plot thickens.
I'm getting sick of this.
Mr. Fernsby?
Mr. Whitmer, you have enough evidence to present your case for Madame Carlyle?
No, not yet.
Come and see me when you do.
I'm so sick of this.
Document this historic moment. Mother apologizing for a cock up.
The first, I believe.
In my own time, Gregory. I'll wait till every. What he is here.
Give him all you got.
That's Madame Carlyle taken care of. Time to get the file on Arthur Edwards.
Find the case file. What? Where is it? Oh. Yeah, now it is. No, you hear me?
That is the door to Rebecca's room.
Alright, let's activate button.
Peculiar icons above the safe. I wonder if they might be some sort of a code. Maybe have a look around the office, 47.
Locate the exit.
Mission complete. Well done, 47.
Now locate the exit. So far. Why cannot cross? You own him nothing.
47. Don't respond, just listen. Diana can't help you now. You need to find Olivia. She'll know what to do.
there were none. Thank you, Miss Burnwood. Now, it's my turn.
Stay down. Boss wants you alive.
Yeah? How about now?
Over here! Cover me!
Walk away!
Or what? You gonna take us all on?
Don't.
Tell the constant to start running!
You think you've won? 47 is out there. And 47 never misses his mark.
Neither do you, Miss Burnwood. That's what makes you valuable.
You're delusional. You think I would betray 47?
Trust me. You owe him nothing.
What is this?
I told you we could help each other. And I meant it. I look forward to your call.
Gray is gone. Go to Berlin and stay out of sight. We're all that's left now.
Continue story, Apex Predator. Contact only you. Okay, I'm done for now. Thanks for watching. Remember the next time I meet. Thank you. Bye.